In this example, we are given with a particle which moves with an acceleration given as 80 plus 6 meters per second square, and we are required to find the displacement of particle at t equal to 3 seconds. If at t equal to 0, it starts from origin with initial speed of 1 meters per second. Again, let's draw the physical situation. Say particle starts at t equal to 0 with the initial speed 1 meters per second and is having an acceleration a given by this expression. Now in this situation, we are required to find the displacement of particle at t equals to 3 seconds. Now, we know well that if we are given with acceleration on integrating this, we get the velocity and on integrating velocity, we get the displacement. So here we use dv by dt is equals to 8t plus 6, as acceleration can be written as dv by dt. It can be further written as dv is equals to 8t plus 6 into dt. If we integrate both the sides, with the relation at t equal to 0, the speed was 1 meters per second, and at a general time t, velocity is say v. On left hand side, when we integrate it, we'll get v. When we apply limits from 1 to v, it is v minus 1. That will be equal to, when you integrate this, it will be 8t square by 2 plus 6t. So here, this gives us the velocity as 4t square plus 6t plus 1 meters per second. This is the velocity as a function of time. Now we are required to find displacement, so we'll further write it dx upon dt. This dx by dt can be written as 4t square plus 6t plus 1. And we can write dx is equals to 4t square plus 6t plus 1 into dt. Now we integrate this expression with the relation that at t equal to 0, particle was at initial position 0, and at a general time t, particle is at a position x. So you can see on integrating, we get the value of x is equals to, this will be 4t cube by 3, plus this will be 6t square by 2, that will be 3t square plus t. Now we are required to find the value of displacement of particle at t equal to 3 seconds. We just substitute t equals to 3. We can say at t equal to 3 seconds, the position can be given as 4 into 3 cube by 3 plus 3 into 3 square plus 3. So here we are going to get it 4 into 9, that will be 36 plus 27 plus 3. So this will be 66 meter. So this is the answer to this question. And you can see we are using the very common relation which we have studied, that on differentiating displacement we get velocity, and on differentiating velocity we get acceleration. So here we are just following the reverse of that. We are given with acceleration. On integrating acceleration we have got velocity, and on integrating velocity we have got the displacement. The only point where you need to be very careful is about the application of limits. The limits must be corresponding on both sides of equality. So be careful about such type of questions.